Hey guys, welcome back to Married with Small Engines. As you can see here, we have lots of equipment to work on and we'll get to it all one by one. Today we are going to work on the carburetor off of this John Deere tractor. I'm going to head into the shop and steal the workbench from my husband. I'll see you in there. We are located in southeastern Ontario, Canada. We do sell new lawn equipment and we take a lot of trade-ins. This photo you're looking at is mostly trade-in machines. We have lots of ideas for upcoming videos. The engine in the John Deere tractor is a Briggs and Stratton Intek Vtwin with a Nikki dual barrel carburetor. We're going to disassemble it, clean it, and rebuild it today. This white plastic part is called a fuel transfer tube. Both of your main jets are sitting in the top of it. They are both different sizes. When you take them out, you'll want to keep track of right from left and make sure to put them back in the exact same way they came out. This little hole I'm pointing at is where the needle sits in the seat. The seat down there is made of brass. You're going to shine a flashlight down there and examine it for corrosion or green color. This seat is non-replaceable. The seat in this carb is in excellent condition. We're going to do a test to see if the needle and seat will hold vacuum. We'll do that in a few minutes. The body of the carb has markings that show left and right jets. I'm using my finger to plug those jets in there. They will fall out if you turn it over, and then you won't know which is which. I'm going to shine my flashlight through the fixed idle jets. You see these two little tiny holes there? They don't come out, but they must be clean. If you put this carb back on the machine and either one of those are plugged, you'll be taking the carburetor back off. Here's how I organize my parts as I take them off the carb. They're in order. I have my jets labeled, and then it's easy to put it back together. Our carburetor is back from cleaning. This carb wasn't very dirty. You can clean carbs by hand, or you can put them through an ultrasonic cleaner. We clean the carb body itself, the float, the nozzle, the fuel transfer tube, and the bowl. I keep this little wire here with a piece of tape on it handy, just in case there's a little piece of something that I can't get out from spray or. So we are going to rebuild this carb with this carb kit right here. Everything we need is in this kit except for new jets. We are going to reuse the jets that we took out. Those were the jets that have a left and a right that we were careful with. We're going to reuse ours. If you need new ones, you can get them separately outside the kit. They have a little O-ring on them. Those O-rings are not replaceable. So if your O-rings are in bad condition, you'll need to get new jets. There, it's almost all back together. We'll give it a look over here to make sure it's working properly before we continue on. Let's go ahead and put our throttle linkage back on. It's easier to put it on now than it is later. One side of this is a hook, and one side of this is like a squiggly little S-bend. The squiggly end of this goes to the carburetor through that hole right there. I will show you.